Kenny Cummins, what up, man? How's it going, dude?
I'm good, man. Thanks for being on the show. I appreciate it, man.
All good, no problem. You already know what it is. Let's do this.
Yes, yeah, so I'm joined with singer, songwriter Kurt Chambers, very talented singer, songwriter, country singer, from LA, Nashville, doing incredible things. Let's get into it. How did you get started into music, man?
Well, let me just specify right now and let everybody know I'm originally from Philadelphia.
Okay.
Yeah, originally from Philadelphia. And I got into it from, I mean, obviously, man, like a lot of us, man, I grew up in church, so I kind of cut my teeth playing in church. And then outside of that, man, it came from just being around a lot of incredible musicians, such as like The Roots and people like that, and Questlove, and just kind of like that hip hop, that early hip hop and neo soul movement, and that kind of like that was kind of like my introduction to the music industry.
I definitely love the Philadelphia music sound, dating back to the 90s for as long as I can remember, and just how the hip hop scene and the soul scene, it was an time for the city of brotherly love. Philly can be labeled as a tough city, I guess, if you're a sports fan or if you're just there in general, but it's a blue collar city. It's, you put in the hard work, you go through the adversity, you get out of there and you succeed. People are, I feel like Philadelphia are very, a lot of passionate people that strives to succeed.
For sure.
So,
Yep. Yep.
I will say that the passion is there. It's like people want others to succeed. It's, you'll go through some knuckleheads every now and then, but
No doubt.
Philly is a good city. I love Philadelphia. It's definitely one of the cities that I want to go to one day and check out their legendary cheesecake, for sure. So.
Yeah, when you roll through Philly, man, you want to get you a soft pretzel, you want to get you a cheesesteak from somewhere in the hood, probably like Max's, you know what I mean?
Yeah.
And then you want to get yourself a tasty cake, and then, that's how you experience Philadelphia for sure.
So I want to talk about these songs that you got. One is called Up in the Air, and the other one is called Roll With It. Now, one of these songs, you had a exclusive premiere that was on Billboard. Which one of those songs that was premiered on Billboard?
That was Roll With It.
Okay.
Yeah, so Roll With It, yeah, the exclusive premiere on Billboard was featured. They featured Roll With It. Yep, that was the one.
So, talk about that song and the whole process of writing it. What's it all about?
Oh, that one was cool because it was pretty much written by me and my friends, and they live in LA and Nashville as well. And we both of us kind of commute back and forth. Their family's in LA, and it kind of like encompasses or embodies our whole energy being in Nashville and writing, great songs, and then still being heavily involved in like the hip hop community in Los Angeles. And that's pretty much where that sound came from. And, just the storyline of Nashville and the musicality, and the production of LA. I really wanted to hybrid that thing together. That's kind of my thing. And that was just the creativity, inspiration behind Roll With It. And like I said, I wrote it with my friends that I've been writing with for years, all new writers, but they pretty much kind of get my sound and what I'm going for. So whenever we get together, we organically nail that. So that's the story behind Roll With It.
So what was it like to have Billboard, premiere that song. What was that like?
It was great, man. Any time that you have a franchise such as that, outlets rather like Billboard and jump on your project and support you, it's always a good thing, man, because it's such a prestigious platform. So it confirms that you're doing something right, and it's very inspirational and makes you want to, keep those relationships open and strive for a better ones. So it's a great feeling.
Yeah, that definitely is a big deal when Billboard wants to get your music out there. Any publication, any platform definitely helps to get your music when you are like an independent or unsigned artist that's just trying to get your music out. So I definitely like this song, Woe With It. And I believe everyone.
Thanks, man. I appreciate it, Kenny.
So, and I definitely think a lot of people are going to roll with it as well. No pun intended. But that song is available on all digital music platforms. So, tell your friends, tell your loved ones. It's kind of nice feel to it. With Valentine's Day weekend, play it for your loved ones on this weekend and for the rest
Absolutely.
Of the year. So, with 2020 already underway and you getting yourself out there, so what's next for Kurt Chambers in the next couple of weeks and months? What you have in store next?
Man, a lot of recording in L.A. and a lot of recording in Nashville. Just working on some new songs, and then also writing and producing on some projects in L.A. as well. So that's the next thing for me, just a consistent grind, definitely look out for some new music in the near future and a lot of content online as well. So that's the next thing that I would say I would like for all the fans and supporters to look for in the near future in 2020. New music, new great content, getting to know who I am and kind of how I operate and what I'm doing. And we're just going to have a fun time just inspiring everybody and just making a lot of noise. Doing what I do best.
Absolutely, man. So if you can look back at all that you have done up to this point, like songs, performances, etc., like do you have like a favorite moment, a favorite memory of your career thus far that just made you be like, wow, this is really happening? Like, what's your favorite moment as a musician?
Favorite moment, man. Damn, man, there are a lot, man. Every day for me is an adventure, man, and music is only one side of it, but probably one of my favorite moments was recently when I was out in New Zealand just playing a show. TVs out when we went in the middle of, nowhere. We were riding around, and one of the instructors was like, "Hey, man, I know you, man. you play country music. I like one of your songs." You know what I mean? That was a good moment for me, just because I was out, playing a show in front of probably 80,000 people with, like, one of the biggest rap stars in the world, but still having people kind of just recognize me for the little bit of momentum that I'm, starting to catch. So that was probably one of the biggest moments for me, so far. So, they're growing, they're growing every day. Like I said, I'm always stretching and trying to make life a moment every day. So, every day there's something that's going to happen within that day that's going to make me feel like, okay, that was a good moment. You know what I mean? I made that, because that's what life is about. It's about making every day just phenomenal, because if that's it, just in case that's your last day, you can say, I went hard and but there's something that I feel like was phenomenal today. But aside from that, yes, I would say that that's one of the biggest moments to date.
Well, check here out Mr. Philadelphia out there in New Zealand. People like living is one thing, man, but you're getting to travel and see a whole different city, a whole different country, continent. and just see how people vibe over there, and people like, hey,
absolutely.
I heard your music, man. Like, you know, that's cool. That's like, man, you impacting people's lives, man. And that's the thing I love about music is that it helps people, man, through trying times. It helps. It makes people love. It makes people want to just escape for a moment, because there's a lot going on in this country, obviously. But anytime you just be at home or be working out and you play that song or whatever, it helps. It can help heal. So salute to all the musicians out there like yourself and doing what you
appreciate
do.
Appreciate it.
That was another thing I wanted to get into. I went through some searching, you know.
What you got? What you find?
I found an episode of Ellen DeGeneres, and you was there playing guitar alongside with one of my favorite artists of all time, someone who hosted the Grammys as of last month, Miss Alicia Keys. Y'all performed her latest song, Underdog. And one thing I love about Alicia is that she don't just put out songs, she put out anthems. That song is an anthem.
For sure.
So what was that like, getting to perform with her on Ellen DeGeneres, who's like the queen of daytime right now?
Yeah, it was great, man. It was great. I mean, you know, like I said, every day is a moment, you know, and that was a cool moment that we had. You know, I've met her before, so briefly, and we worked on something before, but this time we got a chance to really just kind of like, you know, work on something intimately for that performance, and I'm just happy that it was successful and you guys like it and everyone liked it. Obviously, the feeling was just as, it was the same that it was, you know, through your eyes, you know, it felt really authentic and organic, and, you know, that's how we wanted it to feel, and what you felt when you, saw it was what we felt when we were performing it, you know, it just felt really good, and the message that, she wanted to, portray, was portrayed, and it was dope, man. It was really good, and we were just doing what we love, you know, just two voices and two instruments up there, just killing it, you know, spreading that message that we wanted to. So yeah, it was dope. It was really good.
Absolutely. For more info on Kurt Chambers, you can check out his website at kurtchambers.com. That's Kurt, as in the letter C, not the letter K. You know. So that's one of those names that can easily be misspelled or whatnot. I know the feeling, because with my last name, people forget the S at the end. You know, it's easy for people to. So it's Kurt, as in the letter C. KurtChambers.com for all the info on Kurt, what he's got coming up musically and performing, etc. He might go to take over another country, you never know. So just you go there for more details. So you being a country artist, you know, I've grown to listen to country music for several years now. I live in Kentucky, and you know, Kentucky, we have some things going on there on that genre. You know, guys like Chris Stapleton, Sturgill Simpson, and a plethora of other artists. You being an African American and you doing country music, I'll be like, all right, okay, country brother doing the thing. I like it.
And I
vibe with that, you know. And you know, it's Black History Month, so shout out to all the, you know, brothers and sisters making history and everything. But you know, you being a brother doing country music, Like, you know, how do you feel about country music in general that's out, you know, from an artist perspective? How do you feel about country music as of right now?
I mean, it's dope. It's great. It's a growing genre. You know what I mean? You know, it's always been. I mean, it's not a new thing to African Americans. You know what I mean? Like, they were playing banjos and those instruments for years. You know what I mean? I don't remember the correct facts for sure right now. I don't remember what I read, but. It's not a new thing, but right now it's cool because it is a growing genre across the board, and people are just accepting of the new country, the older sounding country, and you know, whatever you look like and all that. So I'm happy about where it came from, you know, how it existed, and where it's going. So yeah, I'm confident and really happy about it.
Absolutely. And you know, country music has definitely evolved, I feel like, throughout the years. A lot of talented artists that's doing their thing, and I feel like it's a lot more open now than it was
Absolutely.
a long, long time ago. So shout out to the country artists out there that's really doing it. For you, Kurt, you definitely have witnessed a lot of awesome things over the course of your career. What would your advice be to anyone out there that wants to become a musician, that wants to get started? What would your advice be?
Man, I would say keep going. You know, it's a bit of a generic answer to that question, but you know, like persistence will beat anything, man. Persistence will beat any resistance. You know, resistance die will wear down after a while. You know what I mean? So that would be my advice, you know. And then the other part, persistence to that advice would be find your believers, man, and rock with them. Get your group of people that believe in you, because people may be able to stop you, or they may not connect with your personality. But if you got a crew of like 5 or 10 people, and all of you guys are doing your thing, man, they can't stop all of y'all. You know, they're gonna like one of, you know what I mean? They're gonna like one of you in the pack. You know, so that would be my advice. That's just kind of how me and my friends got on. When I was 18 years old, man, it was just a crew of us. It was just like, I don't know, about 10 of us, you know, and we all played instruments, and we were all super hungry, you know what I mean? And you just couldn't stop all of us. You may not like one of us, but, you know, we all rolled thick and deep, and we were good. So that's what I would say, man. You're going to get a bunch of no's. It's just the way it is. Everybody gets no's. You know, Pharrell Williams got no's. Timberland got no's. Alicia Keys got no's. They all got the success story. They all got the story of, man, I went to labels, Luke Combs, you know, went to every label in Nashville, and everybody turned them down. Look at them now. You know, you can't really listen to people in the office. They really don't know what the heck they're talking about most of the time. So it's up to you to like really show them that, you know, this is gonna go. You know, I would love to work with you. I want to work with you. You know, but if you don't want to bite, I'm gonna keep going. Somebody's gonna bite. Somebody's gonna get this check with me. So either you're gonna get it, or I'm gonna get it with somebody else. You know, so that's what my advice would be.
That sounds like Mamba mentality to me.
Oh, for sure.
Yeah,
For
so
sure, dude.
rest in peace. Rest in peace to the late great Kobe Bryant and his lovely daughter Gigi and all the other passengers.
Absolutely.
He got some of course he's originally from Italy, but he's got some. He went to school in Philly and
Yeah.
went
Oh,
on to
yeah.
become one of the all-time greats for sure.
Yep.
So
Yep.
go stream the heck out of the song War With It. Go stream the heck out of Up in the Air. Go stream all his music.
All of it.
So all of it, because he's got more in store. So Kurt Chambers gonna keep bringing y'all
Sir.
that good music for you all. And it was great chatting with you, man. Thanks for being on, taking
Thanks.
time off your busy schedule. And
No doubt. Thanks for having me.